pour my tequila, Batman, and pass me the nachos. Caroline Turin has sent us a tweet with an ad from a real estate agent in WA saying all offers considered. Well, why don't we do this? Let's submit an offer for this beautiful two-bedroom, one-car space unit set in a luxurious lifestyle block with a swimming pool. Let's send in an offer for $100 and let's see what we get back. Why don't we just do that, eh? Hold the nachos, pour the tequila, chicos locos. This construction fiasco is really getting out of hand. Now we have building number 4 in Erskineville that has been evacuated for over 12 months. Come on the scene. Now, from my stats, I said over 1,000, so minus 4, that leaves us 996 faulty buildings to be found in New South Wales. How do you like them apples? This whole construction fiasco is gaining more traction than my mate Speedy Gonzalez. So what we're now told is that this building has been built on contaminated land. Well, let me give you some insights into construction in Sydney. A lot of these high-rise buildings that have been built in the last 10, 15 years have been built over old industrial zones, old industrial complexes that in the most part in the 30s, 40s and 50s, the occupants of these industrial complexes did not get rid of the commercial waste or toxic waste substances properly. They simply buried it in their backyard. And now what we have is the local authorities finding out that the current developers have not remediated the land properly. So the housing minister, Michael Zucker, has told buyers to go out and take a chance, take a punt with $600,000, $700,000, $800,000 on what the government believes is a great opportunity to own your first home. I don't know about those odds when you start to take into account the fact that we got a lot of mortgage stress, we're going to have high unemployment rates, and quite frankly, if you've got even a 5% deposit, because let's not forget, the government's gonna give you the other 15%. If you've even got 5% deposit, you know what? I want to think that you have a better chance on the footy, on the trots, or even the star casino by putting it all on black. That's just my opinion, and I'm just saying. Fake data and live data. As I've been saying all along, we need to really look at the data that's been presented by the mainstream media. We need to look at the granularized samples that have been published. It's not enough to just look at the 76% or 72% or the 70% clearance rates. We need to look at the actual numbers that are being sold by way of auction. So the Sydney Morning Herald reports that the state and federal government agree on national building standards. Can I ask one question? When did we not have national building standards? When did the state and the federal government actually stop paying attention to any of these standards or even the local governments? That's a real question that needs to be asked. Now, we're on a bandwagon here. The governments are trying to score brownie points across the board. Quite frankly, it's a disaster zone out there. The ball was dropped in 1988 and 1989 when they actually deregulated the building and the construction industry. Local, state, and federal governments have a lot to answer for. And quite frankly, they're the ones that need to put their hand in their pocket and pay for a lot of the crap that's going on at the moment. But unfortunately, it's us, the taxpayers, that are going to be paying for it. It's your money, my money, that's going to be paying for the money grab and the golden tickets that have been given to builders and developers for the last 15 years. But quite frankly, there's over 5,000 buildings out there with major problems, major issues, and we're only going to find out more and more as time proceeds. I'm just saying. Hold my tequila, Batman, and pass me the nachos. Or better still, pass me the vodka. Sporty, good mate of mine, we've been doing some reconnaissance around recently completed high-rise developments across Sydney, and we have some interesting images and videos to share with you. The images that you're about to see are from construction recently completed in the last 24 months in the area of Liverpool in Sydney. Next week we're going to go over to Parramatta and we're going to talk and discuss what's been going on there. I have spoken and I have been speaking over the years with regard to the overpopulation in terms of residential construction in Parramatta and the effect that construction on a water table has and the detriment that it brings to the area. Well, time is the catalyst, and what we're seeing now is that many of these high-rise residential towers that are being developed close to floodplains and on water tables coming into a lot of strife. Okay, chicos locos, you are our eyes and ears out there in the greater landscape. So if you see any bad construction, or you may even be living in an apartment block that is falling apart around you, send it to us, send us the images. We'll be able to report on these for you and inform the public. Make the public aware of the buildings and the different addresses where people should be very careful in getting involved into, because the government certainly isn't telling us, and other authorities are not telling us, and are allowing people to live in very and under very dangerous situations.